here to promote the Rising Entrepreneurs Program. And the key thing, there are two key points that I want to make. Number one, this is an absolutely unique program, not only in Puerto Rico, but anywhere else.
Why?
It's absolutely unique because we are, when I mentioned this at the beginning, what I said is, we're bringing Silicon Valley to Mayagüez. That is actually literally what we're doing. We're literally bringing Thoma Bravo's business model, our business system, our philosophy of building companies, our executives, our network, straight in to the program with only one purpose and one sole purpose, and that is to help young entrepreneurs all from a nonprofit perspective.
And why are you doing this? Did you have somebody helping you when you were up and coming?
I always had somebody helping me.
You know, why is that important?
I never did anything on my own. And I'm about one thing for young people in Puerto Rico and elsewhere. It's the concept of a chance, but it's more than that. It's a concept of an equal chance. And when you, as a young entrepreneur, as a young person, as a young professional, as a young individual, just get that feeling that you have an equal chance, what you can accomplish and the doors you can open are just amazing. So everywhere in my career, there was somebody along the way that opened that door and gave me that feeling that there was an equal chance. And that feeling leads to good risk-taking, leads to trying new things, leads to entrepreneurialism, and leads to just so many things that are wonderful, and that's what we want to bring. That is the way we're looking to support, through the Rising Entrepreneurs Program, the mission of our foundation, which is to promote social justice in Puerto Rico, to promote a system of more equality and opportunity, and regardless of your socioeconomic background, have a sense that you have an equal opportunity of both personal and professional development.
And then there's a sense that this picked up speed after the hurricane. Is that a right assessment?
That's exactly right. You know, the hurricane brought me personally back into Puerto Rico because there was a crisis. And then once we were here, just seeing the amazing talent, the amazing education level, and the incredible need and opportunity, and the relationships that we developed as well through that process, made us stay and give a commitment and put a commitment on the island.
And so how many people are you looking to benefit, to reach?
Initially, this is a yearly program, and it'll recur every year for the duration, because it's an endowed program. At the beginning, on the first year, we're gonna choose a cohort of around 8 to 10 teams that we then support throughout the year. And the program runs from beginning, really, when we select the candidates or the groups in January, and it runs through May.
And so when you say support, can you define that support? What kind of support is it?
So you're getting to the right point, which is, why is this an absolutely unique program? And let me give you a minute about that. Over the last 20 years, I've built Thoma Bravo. Thoma Bravo has acquired, over that time frame, around 250 software companies with an enterprise value of over $70 billion at the time of acquisition. Through that journey, we've built a model that is based on three pillars: business metrics, proprietary business processes, supported by a group of executives that are the best executives in the software industry. Now, what is the track record from this model? We do software. Now, software applies to everything, but that is our expertise and our focus. If you look at the public markets in the software industry, the public markets everywhere in the world, the software as a service public markets today are valued at $1 trillion. The earnings margin of those companies today, on average, is -6%. Thoma Bravo's companies, the average margin of our companies is 37%. That is our value-added delta from that process. As a result of that, we've generated in the past among the best returns in the private equity industry. And as a result of that, we now have, as part of our group, some of the largest investors in private equity worldwide in the industry. So when you look at this whole system that we have, and this whole model that we have, and this entire network of investors, of companies, of a million business customers around the world, that's what we're gonna bring to these entrepreneurs in Puerto Rico. And I'm really, really excited about that because that is completely unique and it's the basis of a big opportunity going forward.
Now, Puerto Rico is your home. Was Mayagüez your home too? Did you go to school in Mayagüez or were you born in Mayagüez?
Oh, absolutely. As a matter of fact, I saw my two best high school friends randomly when I got to Puerto Rico. I opened up the door of the hotel and they're both from Mayagüez and they just happened to be here. It was unplanned, but it was just great.
So are you from Mayagüez?
So I was born in Mayagüez. I was born in Bellavista. I grew up in different places in Mayagüez. For high school, well, I started in CESO, that's where I learned English. Mm-hmm. And then I finished in La Inmaculada Concepción, and that's when I graduated from high school. So my best friends are from Mayagüez. I grew up in Mayagüez. My dad has been in Mayagüez for so many generations. My mom is from Mayagüez, so yeah.
Okay, and so are you setting up an office? Are you working with the UPR? How is it, you know, how is that taking shape?
Absolutely, we are setting up an office and an entrepreneurial space where this will take place. The actual programming will take place there, and we're setting that up in Mayagüez. The foundation also has a central office in San Juan where a management team resides, and the director of the program will be in Mayagüez.
All right, well, if you have one final message for people, I know that, you know, the recruiting process, the application process is open right now, right? So what do you say to all these people who may be thinking about it?
Apply. You know, that's the message. It does not matter what industry your business is based out of, your idea or concept. It could be agriculture, it could be manufacturing, it could be financial services, it could be software. These concepts apply globally, and this network applies globally to any industry. That's number one. Number two, it doesn't matter where you're based. If you're Puerto Rican, I want to build this business in Puerto Rico, we got you. Apply. And number three, it doesn't matter what stage of development you're in. You could be early stage, you could be at the concept stage, you could have a product, you could even have some sales. We can really, really help you. So the key is to apply and give it a chance.